I have to tell you that I have a long personal history about this concept of the right, the public's right to know. And my dad is a journalist, and when we frequently had discussions at home about the free press and the public right to know and how essential that was to a democracy. And in 1968, my family was living in Hawaii, and my father was a radio news broadcaster, and he and a number of local journalists formed the Big Island Press Club for the primary purpose of encouraging the county of Hawaii to include an open meeting provision in their county charter. They were successful in their original goal, but shortly thereafter, they actually had to sue the county for violations of that very same provision. The court upheld that lawsuit. The state of Hawaii upheld the lawsuit, and the judge stated that the right to know is one of the most basic and most important rights of the people. That occurred nearly 40 years ago, but it's very important that we stay vigilant because times have changed. The way we do government has changed. Technology has changed. We can never forget that we exist for the goodwill of the public. And so I would encourage my colleagues to move forward with creating a citizens' task force and bringing back a sunshine ordinance to this council. And it's because I believe that we need to send a clear message to the public, to the staff, to current and future councils, boards, and commissions that the city of Encinitas does in fact value open and transparent government. Transparency is the foundation of an ethical government, and local policies that go beyond the minimum send a clear message and instill public trust and confidence in their local government. I did take the time to review the sunshine ordinances from the other cities, and while that wasn't certainly a requirement of the staff report, I think it's important to understand that they all had goals and values in them that sent this message to the public. It's not just random acts of following the rules. And the city of Benicia ordinance states, it is the goal to make it easier for people to access city government so that they may be more informed about what their city is doing, so that they may be involved in a more meaningful and knowledgeable way, open meetings, easier access to public records, ethical guidelines, and a watchdog commission will help increase the public trust and confidence in city government and will increase public awareness and knowledge about their government. A well-educated public and ethical officials are essential to good government. And I think that that's what we're missing here. I actually went to our website today because this is the means in which the public finds out about its governments. And then except for one sentence on the agenda that is right before the beginning of our call to order, it says this: Encinitas City Council welcomes you and encourages your continued interest and involvement in the city's decision-making process. That was the only statement I could find that stated our values and principles concerning open government. And so while we may comply, we certainly don't tell anybody that that is our intent and that we hold that the public trust sacred. I'm sure that others will say that this is not necessary and that we do a good job, but I really do want us to set a higher goal than just good enough, because Encinitas isn't just good enough. We should strive to do the best, not the least. The citizens of Encinitas deserve nothing less. And I would ask that the council create a citizens task force to work with staff to craft a sunshine ordinance, reviewing the current ordinances that other cities are using, and return to council within 90 days with their recommendation of our sunshine ordinance.